أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
وإن من شيعته لإبراهيم إذ جاء ربه بقلب سليم إذ قال لأبيه وقومه ماذا تعبدون أئفكا آلهة دون الله تريدون فما ظنكم برب العالمين فنظر نظرة في النجوم فقال إني سقيم فتولوا عنه مدبرين فراغ إلى آلهتهم فقال ألا تأكلون ما لكم لا تنطقون فراغ عليهم ضربا باليمين فأقبلوا إليه يزفون قال أتعبدون ما تنحتون والله خلقكم وما تعملون قالوا ابنوا له بنيانا فألقوه في الجحيم فأرادوا به كيدا فجعلناهم الأسفلين.
A moral from this we learn is, if we invite others to the truth of Allah and we ourselves live as true believers in Allah, having a heart safe and clear of shirk, ensuring that Allah is the only one and the highest one in our love, devotion, obedience and worship, if we ensure that in our hearts and actions, then Allah will keep us safe from worldly harms, even by miraculous means, as Allah made the fire cool and safe for Prophet Ibrahim.
وقال إني ذاهب إلى ربي سيهدين رب هب لي من الصالحين فبشرناه بغلام حليم.
A moral from verses 99-101. If we sacrifice our beloved things for sake of Allah, such as migrating to live in a place to protect our iman, then Allah increases us in the good that He gives us of this world, even by miraculous means, as Allah gave Prophet Ibrahim a baby at a very old age.
فَلَمَّا بَلَغَ مَعَهُ السَّعِي قَالَ يَا بُنَيَّ إِنِّي أَرَى فِي الْمَنَامِ أَنِّي أَذْبَحُكَ فَانْظُرْ مَاذَا تَرَى قَالَ يَا أَبَتِ افْعَلْ مَا تُؤْمَرُ ستجدني إن شاء الله من الصابرين فلما أسلما وتله للجبين وناديناه أن يا إبراهيم قد صدقت الرؤيا إنا كذلك نجزي المحسنين إن هذا لهو البلاء المبين وفديناه بذبح عظيم وتركنا عليه في الآخرين سلام على إبراهيم كذلك نجزي المحسنين إنه من عبادنا المؤمنين وبشرناه بإسحاق نبيا من الصالحين وباركنا عليه وعلى إسحاق ومن ذريتهما محسن وظالم لنفسه مبين.
Here are some morals from the amazing verses 102-113. The more and better we sacrifice our worldly things out of obedience of Allah, the more amazing good Allah gives us in this life and in the everlasting life. Prophets Ibrahim and Ismail, alayhim as-salam, as mentioned in these verses, went out to sacrifice one of the most precious of their worldly loves, that is, Ismail's life and Ibrahim's son. Allah, as a reward, help them in seven ways for one sacrifice. The first, accepting their good deed. Second, Allah let them keep the life and the son and did not take those away. The third, Allah gave them easier alternatives to sacrifice instead, the ram, and made obedience of Allah easier. Fourth, Allah made them role models for all time to come. Fifth, Allah gave them peace, salam. Sixth, Ibrahim was about to sacrifice away one son Ismail for Allah, yet Allah let Ibrahim keep that son Ismail and gave Ibrahim one more son, Ishaq. And seventh, Allah blessed the life not only of Prophet Ibrahim, who did the precious sacrifice, but also blessed lives of his son Ishaq and his descendants of future generations. All these seven things Allah gave to Ibrahim for his one sacrifice done in obedience of Allah.